like that, you like that, so let's be crazy. The contact, impact, I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente, está mal de la mente. Cuando está solita que entre, música para ponerla en ambiente, yeah. Ella quiere que coma aquella bella, le busque otro. Todo lo que se pone bonito se le ve. Empezamos a pie y ahora andamos en el jet. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar, baby.
Cause I can't get enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Latino camp.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Alexis Morgan here with a guest who needs no introduction, Mr. Shaquille O'Neal.
Coming up moments from now, the venue in the heart of downtown New York City, the Pistons taking on the Knicks. For the Pistons, the chance to start the year right with a win on the road and give their fans, no matter where they are, something to cheer about. Knicks, Pistons, the tip-off coming up right after this.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Tonight, it'll be the Detroit Pistons going up against the New York Knicks. For New York, they are hungry for a win here. Last season, they got swept by this team. Four straight losses, something they haven't forgotten. And here we are, game one of the new season. Kenny, every team coming in with a clean slate.
Yeah, because whatever you had troubles in last year, that doesn't matter. This is a new year. Be optimistic until proven otherwise.
I'm just looking forward to spending another year with you guys. It's family. And Ernie, you're looking 10 years younger.
Thank you so much. I'm feeling 10 years younger as well, Sean.
It's all exercise, isn't it?
And you're looking like, what are you? You're down to, what, 275?
No, 575.
575.
Lost 15 pounds.
Yeah. Wow. Unbelievable. Kenny? I grew some hair.
Did you? Yeah, you did.
That's a wig.
All right. Y'all still there? Good.
Miss you guys too.
This is it. Opening day. The regular season is set to begin, and we're thrilled to bring you all the live action right here on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan, and by my side, Greg Anthony and Brent Berry. And from the sideline, David Aldridge. A chance now to check out the Knicks' upcoming schedule. On Friday, they'll take on John Wall and the Washington Wizards. And then on Wednesday, it'll be the Atlanta Hawks coming into town. And now the opening lineup for Detroit. On the front line, the talented duo of Griffin and Drummond. Reggie Jackson out there with Rose. And it's Brown in at the three spot. And for the Knicks, Barrett Knox are the wingman. It's Randle and Robinson at the four and the five. And it's Smith in at the one spot. The starting gate, opening night in the NBA. Brent, what are you most looking forward to?
I just like to see who it is that, in terms of their competitive spirit right now, is coming out of training camp hungry. Let's see in the next couple weeks which team jumps out and which coaching staffs have done a great job preparing their team coming out of camp. Now, we know that teams can fall off, Kevin, that talent will catch up. Other veteran teams may get themselves back into a rhythm. But coming out of training camp, how much more together are teams and teams that have made changes? What are they playing like now?
What's their chemistry? Exactly.
Let's find out how they're going to play this year.
Here's Jackson shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
And as long as Reggie Jackson is healthy, he's going to give you some punch as a lead guard. Solid scoring option and a guy who's also unselfish in terms of getting his teammates involved.
And he knocks down the first one. And for the last half decade, Reggie Jackson has been good for about 15 points a game.
And that is about the consistency you can expect from Jackson. He's always been a talent. The key for him is just staying on the floor.
He hits both from the stripe.
Now you can tell he's feeling confident right now at the line, and when he's on, he can be lights out.
Smith inside. Jackson on him. Brown kicks to Griffin. And there's the big-time jam as he slams it right over Randle.
Wow, what a moment right there. Griffin putting on a show. He is just an awesome dunker.
About a minute played so far here in the first. Now let's send it over to David Aldridge, who was able to talk with head coach David Fizdale.
Well, Kevin, this team does have some powerful finishers inside, and he said that option is always going to be one for them. He said, when in doubt, I want our guys to be aggressive, get inside, and force the defense to collapse. That creates inside-out opportunities. Kevin, that's the game plan. Back to you.
Okay, David, thanks. Now, here is Smith following the miss by Derrick Rose. Here's Barrett. That one, no good. Good D by Drummond. From deep. Rose, no good.
And that was a little bit of a range check for him.
Well, I thought they played smart, and then all of a sudden it was maybe a little too flashy there, and that's unfortunate.
Rose can't get that one to fall. The Knicks have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Now the pass to Smith. Wants to get it to Robinson and up. Count that bucket.
That's an easy shot provided by Dennis Smith Jr.
Outside Rose. Here's the three. He's just scored his first basket with that shot, making him 1-for-4.
And that's exactly what he's looking for, draining the triple.
Rose with the double team. Barrett the pass to Robinson. Smith for three. It's Reggie Jackson with the rebound. Detroit's gone 1-of-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Drummond, the shot's good. Brown making the play.
A tall and powerful big. Drummond has a natural ability to finish inside.
And here's Smith. Inside, Griffin with the steal. Makes it off the glass. Rose has got his second basket of the night.
this is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Barrett, wide open, he fires, drains the three-pointer.
Showing improvement in that aspect of his game, Barrett wants to get better firing off the catch.
The drive by Jackson, Robinson with the block. Smith surveying the D, and Randle throws it down.
This guy is a high flyer, I mean, especially for a power forward, and he needs to be as an undersized player.
Knicks trail by four. To the middle. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Randle's got 6 points.
The strength and the quickness and now the confidence coming along as Randle's able to score.
Robinson with the block. And that one's good. Drummond. And it's the Knicks with the ball. And Brown over to help. Pass to Barrett. Throws it up high. Out of bounds. Detroit takes possession.
And a quick check of the stats for Drummond. He's coming off an excellent season. First in rebounding, eighth in steals, and he finished among the top 10 in blocks, bringing that intimidation factor to the paint.
And getting back to the fact that he led the league in rebounding, you know how hard that is? What a tremendous asset to the team. That one drops for him. Smith with it. No points in the game yet for him. And there's the call on Andre Drummond. That is his first foul of the game. On defense, Detroit. 6-point game.
And they've done a nice job controlling the defensive backboard to start this game.
Jackson, that one drops for his second bucket. Mark him 2 for 4.
Yeah, that's the kind of passing that opens up the eyes to Blake Griffin's overall talent.
Pass to Smith. Rebounded by the Pistons. Drummond's got 6 rebounds in the game. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2. Julius Randle picks one up.
Griffin staying strong down low. Even when he knows the hit is coming, Kevin, great concentration and toughness shown there.
A free throw drops for Griffin. And for Blake Griffin, always a great outside shooter for the power forward position, Greg, but he's added range the last few seasons.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen Griffin go from a guy who might take 1-3 a game to someone putting up about 6 a night. The results have been there for him as he shoots a respectable rate from beyond.
Both good from the line that time.
And guys, one thing that has been interesting to see since Blake Griffin came to Detroit is how he's developed as a leader, has come into his own with how he takes responsibility for the team's play.
Here's Brown. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Timeout, timeout.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
And so New York calls timeout. They're first. And with Griffin, you look at his time on the Clippers, and for most of his career, he was more of a second in command.
Coach Casey said last year, early on, that Griffin is the leader of this team, and Blake took it upon himself to step up to the challenge. Makes sense, no matter how you look at it, he's their best player and needs to be one of the leaders.
We'll be right back.
that we have a chance, let's go to the 2K leaderboard and reveal last season's top shot blockers. You look at Robinson, second in the NBA, a great defender.
And shot blocking is the element of the game that I think he cares about the most. That's where he puts in that effort and energy.
Jackson against Smith. Randle outside. Griffin on the double team. They need this. And it's sent back by Drummond.
A high motor keeps Drummond engaged defensively. He doesn't want to let any shots go in. And the defense looks soft early on. They've got to sum it up. A little more sense of urgency.
And Randle throws it down.
He just punched the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam. Brown. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain the momentum.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
So it's the Knicks now. After the basket by Detroit, Knox misses. Rose looking around. Over Barrett. And it's Rose missing.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
Making plays in traffic. This is where Barrett's most effective.
Here's Griffin, the 15-footer. Good. Griffin's got 10.
It just seems like the more he touches it, the more the lead grows.
Jackson against Smith. Passes to Randle. Score the bucket. He's made five so far, shooting a very clean 5 of 7.
Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
And now the first timeout called here for Detroit. You know, officials try to be as objective as possible. Brent, it does sometimes feel like we get superstar calls, correct?
I think there's absolutely superstar calls, Kevin. And, you know, the purist in me wants the referees to keep it fair. But understanding that the game is entertainment and understanding what it takes to be that level of player, every now and then seeing a guy like James Harden getting a few more free throws or watching Giannis find his way to the line a few more times, I shrug my shoulders and I say, yeah, I actually kind of get it.
Yeah, good examples. So, New York going with almost an entire new group here. Portis, he's checked in for Robinson. Gibson comes in for Julius Randle. Marcus Morris is checked in for Kevin Knox. And it's Reggie Bullock in for Barrett. Then for the Pistons, Dumboya is checked in for Brown. Luke Kennard comes in for Derrick Rose. And Langston Galloway subbed in for Reggie Jackson. And the foul on Dennis Smith Jr. That is his first foul of the game.
That's his first foul.
Here's Drummond. Detroit, no good that time either. And so it's Morris with it. He'll bring it up for the New York Knicks. Down by 12. Here's Smith, and it's sent back by Drummond.
You know, he might want to think about deferring for a while. He's had his chances this quarter, but just not able to convert. Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Yeah, if you walked in at any point during this game to watch 5 minutes of play, one team played harder. We know who that was.
And Morris throws it down.
Yeah, just aggressive there. Instead of going to one of his patented shots inside, Morris just simply rises up to be free.
Smith, left side. Here's Portis. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It's going to be on Blake Griffin.
Yeah,
And the former Razorback, Bobby Portis, took a few years to find his spot in the NBA. But now, he does produce.
And great big man to bring in off the bench. Good size and quickness combination, and will always give you scoring with that second unit.
Shooting two.
No good on that one. Trier, he's checked in for New York. So he comes up empty at the line. Pistons leading by 12. Here's Kennard. That drops. And it comes off an assist from Griffin.
Well, Blake Griffin can't find his teammates. The timing on that play, impressive.
For three, Bullock. It's Drummond with the rebound. Drummond's got his eighth rebound here tonight. Here's Dumboya. Another three for Detroit.
Just playing with poise and confidence. Man, they continue to put points on the board.
Yeah, just really pouring it on right now, trying to take away the opposition's motivation to keep competing in this one.
And Morris throws it down.
And that's a little lack of fight at the defensive end.
Absolutely. At least on that slam, you're right. That's one way to let a team back in the game.
You have to credit the aggressiveness offensively, because that's when you make a play when you really need it.
Here's Trier following the three by Detroit. Gibson in the post, defended by Griffin. Now, here's Portis. Tight defense on him. Shot clock at five. Here's Morris. And it's sent back by Drummond. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation. Detroit leading by 18. To the paint from 12 feet out. And Detroit again with the bucket.
Just how awesome is it to watch the best of the best start to dominate in a game?
Here's Trier. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Outside Portis. A three-pointer, no good. Detroit's gone 3 of 5 from three-point land so far in the ballgame. That one off the back iron and out.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
And again, it's the Knicks missing.
They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game.
Dumboya, good.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket. The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Not going to go that time. The Knicks go the other way with it. There's 1:17 left to play in the first quarter. Bullock, good.
Look at the space he had on that one, though. There's an obvious speed mismatch between the two.
And plenty of contact on the shot, so two free throws coming up. And the foul goes against New York. The Pistons shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game.
At the line for two.
That's good from Dumboya. And the Knicks making a change here. Ellington's checked in. Then for the Pistons, Markieff Morris has checked in for Andre Drummond. And it's Frazier in for Blake Griffin. And so he makes both from the line. And a trying summer for the New York Knicks fans. After trading away Porzingis, they were hoping to get a big-name player in free agency, Greg, and they didn't.
You know, shocking, they refused to offer the max to Kevin Durant. I mean, there were concerns with the Achilles, but instead he ends up in Brooklyn. combine that with fans' disappointment at missing out on Zion Williamson, and the saga continues.
The Knicks shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
And going back a season ago, they were a pretty average team at the line, about 76% altogether.
Shooting two.
That free throw, no good.
Taj Gibson is tough, proven veteran who plays well on both ends of the court.
And he's good on the second. So for the Pistons, their last game, a win against Dallas. Here's Frazier. They grab their own miss. Doom Boya. Great D that time from Portis.
I'm a fan of anybody who defends that way. I mean, they weren't about to open the door and just allow him to cruise in for a layup.
Here's Trier. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. There's 31 seconds left to play in the first. Galloway with the bucket.
Beautiful transition offense there. That's execution at its best.
Yeah, once you burst through a seam like that, you got to look right towards the rim. Sweet play.
Now, here is Morris. Coming off a stellar performance against Washington. Portis kicks to Morris. The pass to Ellington. Four on the shot clock. New York needs to get off a shot, and Portis throws it down.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. And so it's the Detroit Pistons in very good shape with a 23-point lead at the end of the quarter. And it's been their rugged defense setting the tone. We've got more in store for you right after this. Bobby Portis, who's known for his work ethic, said he learned a lot from his mother.
She gets up at 3, 4 in the morning and gets off at 1, 2 in the evening. You know, she works hard for her four boys. You know, she breaks herself off daily. You know, I always try to pride myself in hard work also because how hard she worked for me.
And she was a basketball player in her own right, Greg, a scholarship at Jackson State University.
Yeah, and gave up basketball when she had Bobby, but she encouraged him to pursue his dream, and she said now she's living her dream through him.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And the Pistons have been rolling right along, haven't they?
Yeah, in that first period, they looked to push in transition at every opportunity.
Yeah, felt like they knew that there were openings in transition and just wanted to keep trying to feed that, get out quick.
And Detroit, looking at who they've got. Doom Boya is out there with Kennard. Then there's Markieff Morris. Then there's Frazier. And it's Galloway in at the two-guard spot. Now here's Ellington. Frazier covering. And it's Gibson finishing it off.
Got to keep Taj out of the post. How many of those have we seen?
Doom Boya. Good. Great play set up by Frazier. Frazier's got three assists in the game. Feeds it to Gibson. And it's Gibson finishing it off.
Not getting old here. Seeing him make that lead pass with perfect timing.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, in Blake Griffin, the Pistons have their biggest star in years, probably going back to their championship team of 2004. A return to all-star form for Blake meant tremendous individual numbers last season. And the Pistons hadn't won a playoff game in more than a decade. Still not the result they want in 2019. Pistons will be trying to capitalize during Blake's prime. Kevin, we'll see where this franchise goes from here.
We sure will, David, but he's a terrific player. Thank you so much. And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. Here's Trier, and he makes good on the layup.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with their work down low.
And I just love the skill set that Markieff Morris has, Greg, at that forward position.
He really is a do-it-all type of forward for this team. Can step outside and shoot, but has no problem guarding anyone on the front line of the opposition.
Let's it fly from 18. Here's Dumboya. That's in. That's his fifth field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%, 5-for-7. New York calls timeout. Brent, certain players make everyone around them better. Talk about some of those guys who will do that at the very highest level.
The interesting thing about today's game, Kevin, is it's not always the point guard position. I think in the past we thought two ways. The point guard, who has the ball in his hands, finding guys for them to make shots. And then through the 80s and 90s, it was low post players who were getting double teams and initiating some offense.
Yes.
Nowadays, it's a lot of wing guys. And it's guys like Kawhi Leonard. It's guys like LeBron James, Kevin Durant. Throw Draymond Green in there with his ability to pass the ball. Jokic in there with his ability to pass the ball. It's all happening around the three-point line and getting into the gaps. So they look a little bit different, the initiators, in today's game.
Group in for the Knicks. Mitchell Robinson's checked in for Bobby Portis. Randle comes in for Taj Gibson. Knox, he's checked in for Marcus Morris. And Barrett subbed in for Trier. And the Pistons making a change here as well. Rose, he's checked in for Langston Galloway. The shot by Ellington, no good.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Rose, that's good.
Yeah, he's going to knock that down if you give it to him. Uncompetitive there defensively.
Well, defense also looking defeated. The lack of hustle is driving the coaching staff a little bit batty right now.
Barrett, no good. Detroit with the ball. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Dumboya can't get it to go.
Not a bad shot from the mid-range. The D's giving it to him, and he's usually got an eye in that kind of range.
That one goes in. 12 points for Julius Randle.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
Morris with the bucket. Now Ellington. He picked up 12 points in their last win against the Wizards in Washington. And he gets it to go. Ellington's got his first bucket of the night.
Nicely done. They continue to attack inside, and that's 10 points in a row in the paint.
Morris, no good.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take. Oh, just a picture-perfect alley-oop. You got to love that one, Kevin.
A little surprise, Greg. He didn't go for the big slam, but it works just the same. Bucket is good.
And a lot of teams avoid the mid-range jumper, but they seem to be using it well.
Here's Ellington. Sinks that one from the post. Ellington's got his second bucket of the night.
Yeah, they've raised their shooting percentage in this quarter, and they're starting to get on track.
It's not his best night from the field, but looking for other ways and finding them so he can chip in.
And Barrett gets it to go.
I just think that's trouble. You're gonna let that guy shoot layups. You're asking for it. Sweet to be a difference maker in the game, and he's been a great option for them on these possessions.
Bounce pass from Ellington. Here's Randle. It's tipped. Fires high post, and it's Rose. This time the assist by Frazier. Rose has got 9.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Down low, here's Barrett in the hoop for his fourth field goal. 4-for-7 shooting and looking for more.
I don't know what's happening defensively, but they're not putting up any resistance.
But they get it back. Near the three-point line, it's Morris, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Julius Randle picks one up. Pistons have been excellent at the free throw line here today, a flawless 6-for-6.
And they were 75% from the line a season ago.
He misses the free throw. Smith checked in for Wayne Ellington. Then for the Pistons, Blake Griffin comes in for Dumboya. And it's Bruce Brown in for Kennard. And he sinks the second. Brent, when constructing a team, it's always tricky to fit in max contracts. But the truth is, some players probably deserve much more money than they're allowed to receive.
Incredible to say that, right,
it
Kevin?
Is, yeah.
But there are guys like LeBron James, whose $35 million contract might be worth $100
million. I always thought about Jordan, too, right? I mean, my goodness.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. And for the years that Michael Jordan was underpaid in Chicago for what it was he was doing. But in terms of competitive balance for the league and 30 franchises, and for you to try to build a team and a roster to put out on the floor to play this game and have opportunities to win championships, it's really the only way, and sometimes unfairly for guys in terms of their competition and compensation, to have to put maximums on what it is that players can earn.
And it's Smith missing.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Boy, he launched that one from way outside. That's 12 points for Rose.
Yeah, that first quarter was a bit shaky. Good to see a player who doesn't let a slow start get to him.
That one good for two.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Griffin. Smith with the defensive effort. New York shooting 48% from the field. Not bad at all. Here's Randle, and the layup's good off the glass. Randle's got 14 points for the game.
And you see the passing instincts Barrett has. Great at recognition out on the floor.
And Kevin Knox gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. Reggie Bullock, he's checked in for the Knicks. Andre Drummond's checked in for Detroit. Jackson comes in for Frazier. Off the inbound, and that one off the back of the rim and in. 6 points for Drummond.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Smith against Jackson. Here's Robinson. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Robinson's got 6 points in the quarter.
Second chances are a great measure of what a team is doing in terms of their effort on a nightly basis, and that was some serious effort there.
And you want more of this from Jackson. The more unselfish he is, the better the team.
Jackson against Smith. Pass to Bullock. Takes a three. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Smith's got assist number 9 now. Wow, what an effort here tonight. And so it's Jackson who brings it up for the Detroit Pistons. Following this one, they get to host the Cavaliers. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again.
And now you can see the D having problems stopping the mid-range jumper, just not really closing out as much as they need to.
And that one is good.
Yeah, this story in the second quarter, much different than the one in the first. We're finally seeing some aggression.
The shot's good from Griffin.
Well, strong and explosive, Griffin knows how to use his body to protect that ball in traffic.
Bullock kicks to Randle. To the inside. Bullock, good. Bullock's got 7 points.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over. Well, after passing on drafting him at the 8th pick in 2017, the Knicks got Dennis Smith anyway, and he's a big part of their future.
Be interesting to see offensively how it is that Dennis Smith grows under David Fizdale and how they're going to operate this season. Obviously, you want to be an extension if you're the point guard of the coaching staff. Lots of pressure on Dennis Smith to perform consistently for this Knicks team to remain competitive.
Here to check out some stats on Blake Griffin. Last season, he played outstanding. Last season, put up about 24 points per, 7 rebounds, and 5 assists. And it says a lot that when we see numbers like this from him, we aren't even shocked. He's that good.
Yeah, we really have just grown to get used to his greatness, and that's the level for him that he's on right now.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Count that one. 8 points for Drummond. New York's gone 1-6 from three-point land in the second quarter. Less than 20%, but they've continued to let him fly. Here's Bullock. Score the basket. His fourth. He's only missed one of his 5 shots tonight.
Yeah, field goal percentage above 50 now. Their offense is starting to show.
Brown, good. Here's Smith. He's got 6. Pass to Robinson. Randle left side. New York moving the ball around. Barrett makes the bucket. Now he's got 5 field goals, 5 for 8 in the game.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Drummond. Robinson with the block, and he gets it back. And that one's good. Drummond. 1:50 left now here in the second. Smith the pass to Barrett. To the middle. Here's Randle, and Randle throws it down.
You wonder if the coaching staff is encouraging these kind of nights and aggressive play from Randle to take over.
And the foul on Dennis Smith Jr. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. And the Knicks making a change here. Morris has checked in. And the Pistons making a change here as well. Galloway has checked in. Off the inbound. But they'll get another chance. It's blocked. Here's Drummond. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot. Drummond's got 12. The Knicks shooting an outstanding 53% for the game. Randle outside. From 13. Offensive rebound. Pistons leading by 22. Here's Drummond. That misses off the backboard. Smith against Jackson. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Well, few players in the NBA are as scary as Dennis Smith Jr. when he has speed towards the rim.
Smith just attacks with a ferociousness when he puts the ball on the floor. It can leap out of the building and strong enough to dunk over and through just about any player. Still developing the rest of his game, but you like his aggression when going to the hoop.
First free throw is good.
The 9th pick in the 2017 NBA draft, Smith Jr. made the NBA's all-rookie team after a very solid first year in Dallas, averaging 15 points and 5 assists, and he sure is not looking to stop there.
Portis, he's checked in for New York. Gibson comes in for Barrett. Smith hits them both.
Well, Fizdale, part of those great teams in Miami as an assistant coach with Eric Spoelstra, He coaches with a lot of fire and enthusiasm, is very involved emotionally in what his team does on a daily basis, and it's why a lot of these young players are gravitating towards his coaching style.
Outside, Portis kicks it to Bullock. Smith wide open, he fires, and the Knicks miss again.
Maybe there are ways to contribute that don't involve shooting the basketball. That's the best way that maybe he can help them out in trying to win this game.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Bullock passes to Gibson. Bullock, good. Bullock's got 11.
And that keeps him perfect from the field this quarter.
The shot. Jackson misses.
And we haven't seen them be quite as aggressive, driving the basketball, settling far too much for jumpers.
Nice shot by Smith.
Smith Jr. getting inside that time.
5 seconds left in the first half. Here's Jackson. Chalk up two there. Jackson's got 6 in the quarter.
Resourceful move there. That was not an easy one to convert.
No. Showing off a little bit on that one. That's a play when your coach goes, no, okay, good play. Get back on defense.
So as we conclude the first half, so far fairly one-sided. Pistons ahead, just dominating this one. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Andre, big first half, a lot of energy. What are you guys doing differently tonight?
With active hands and the defensive end, it really got us all hyped up. And, you know, it translates to the offensive end as well, too. So, you know, we're looking real good right now. We just got to put it together in the second half, too.
Transition really working well for you in the first half, Andre. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny, and a favorite time of the year as we're halfway through one of the first games of this fresh NBA season. Detroit finds themselves ahead after two quarters. They are in blowout territory, leading by 20. Kenny, what do you think?
There's been one thing that's made a difference in this game above all else: their control of the backboard. They put forth an amazing effort on the glass, and the rebounding numbers aren't even close, Ernie. That'll be something to keep an eye on in the second half. They will be very tough to contain if that continues.
And Shaq, what are your thoughts on New York?
Well, you live by the three and you die by the three. And today, they're dying. And as cold as they've been behind the arc, they keep firing from deep. What are you doing? I know they got a lot of ground to make up, but they can't continue with this game plan. Not working.
Thanks for joining us, folks. We're now just a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. We're seeing a tremendous game from Julius Randle.
Yeah, pretty much all throughout that first half, and he was taking care of his business on the low blocks and getting more than his fair share of dunks.
Yeah, there's not any guy defensively that was bodying him up or contesting the shot, so right now he's feasting.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. It's Randle and Robinson at the 4 and the 5. Barrett and Knox are the wingmen, and it's Smith in at the point. And that's the group for David Fizdale as we begin the second half.
When Dennis Smith Jr. is dropping those kind of passes, it's going to help the offense just run a bit more smooth.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Kevin, before he became a head coach in Memphis and New York, David Fizdale spent 8 seasons as an assistant under Eric Spoelstra in Miami. Now, Spo said he's a brilliant basketball mind that has exceptional gold standard level communication skills. One of the most talented coaches I've been around. So, Kevin, Fizdale is highly respected.
David, he sure is. Great reputation. Now getting his shot. Thank you so much. Jackson, that's good.
changing ends quickly, he's rewarded with a high percentage look.
Yeah, the defense trying to do their best to slow him down, but when he gets room like that, you got to look out.
Randle, no good.
Yeah, better than giving up the layup. You want to go in there and use the hard foul. They did it there. That's aggressive attitude defensively.
And boy, what a year it was for Derrick Rose and the sea of fans hoping that he would get back to what he once was, as he was electric.
Shooting two.
And the first one at the line is good. And for Rose, so many had written him off, but he was a huge factor for the Timberwolves.
Rose still has a tremendous passion for the game, and it really shows on the court. His renaissance last season was one of the better stories in our league.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
And you gotta love watching Rose play the game. His intense style can be infectious out there, and I think it really does elevate his teammates.
That's one for their first four to start the second half.
It's rebounded by Barrett. The Knicks have gotten just one of their first four shots to fall since coming out of the locker room at the break. And Randle throws it down.
Randle with a great effort there, up and athletic and at the rim.
Here's Jackson, and they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
And this is his second trip to the line tonight.
And when you shoot 86 from the line like he did last season, you usually cash in on those opportunities.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
Just over a minute and a half played here in the third. Jackson against Smith. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
Dennis Smith Jr. just playing hard right now and using some of that force from the point guard position.
He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots of the game right here.
Line for two.
First one falls for him. So after making the first, he goes one for two. Well, you look at the former All-Star Andre Drummond and the way he rebounds, Greg. He might be the best in the league in that department.
Few players in the history of the league can go off for 20-plus rebounds on any given night. Drummond's one of them. Attacks the glass on the offensive end so well. His offensive rebounding, for me, sets him apart.
And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. Julius Randle picks one up.
There's some unique qualities to the play of Blake Griffin, a big with incredible handles and passing skills who can still throw it down.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes the first. Luke Kennard, he's checked in for Brown. That one falls, so he hits both of them. And so it's Smith with it. He'll bring it up for the New York Knicks. And Smith gets double-teamed. New York moving the ball around. And the dunk by Robinson.
Pretty sweet pass there as Knox showing his ability to read the floor.
From deep, Rose. Robinson pulls it in. Robinson's got 8 rebounds in this game. The feed now to Barrett. And Barrett slams it in.
Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
Detroit leading by 18. Kennard kicks to Griffin. Over Randle. Nice spin off the left rim and in. Griffin's got 18 points in the game.
That's another area that Griffin has worked on. Just taking the pass and creating rhythm with the shot. D can't stop it.
Smith with it. And Griffin picks him up defensively. And it's Smith missing. Detroit's gotten fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4 for 9. Griffin attacking. That's a basket. His 8th from the field, 8 of 14.
Griffin showing the total package now, lightning quick on his way to the hole.
Down low, here's Randle. Rebound, Detroit. Drummond's got his 18th rebound here tonight, all over the place. Griffin passes to Jackson. Tries from 16. Here's Drummond. No good. The Knicks go the other way with it. Smith drives in, uses the glass to finish the layup. He's got 13.
That's a pretty gritty play there by Dennis Smith Jr.
Jackson from long range. Pistons keep it alive.
Yeah, maybe a little luck, maybe a little bit of heart. Both of those at play here. He's getting every offensive rebound. I mean, he's going to punish you, Kevin, if you leave him open. He's more than willing to take the open three when he's got it.
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over.
Yeah, he needs to tell his guys to just box out with some energy. That's basic basketball. They've been lazy on the backboard and have allowed way too many second chance points.
Different look for New York. Lonzo Trier comes in for Robinson. And Ellington is subbed in for Dennis Smith. Detroit also making some changes. Markieff Morris is checked in for Griffin. Dumboya comes in for Derrick Rose. And Tim Frazier is subbed in for Jackson. Detroit leading by 21.
Come to me.
Here's Dumboya. Here's Drummond. And terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up 2. Drummond's got 14.
Pursues the offensive glass with purpose. Drummond knows who he is, and boy, does he attack it.
He's not the reason that they're trailing in this one. He's been on his game. There's a few of the other guys that need to pick it up. Yeah, undersized guys with athleticism do these kind of things, playing above the rim. Love to see him get up like that.
Ellington the pass to Knox. Here's Randle, and Randle throws it down.
And he gives that rim a good tug on the way down.
Well, that's how you drive your point home right there. Kennard. The shot comes out. The Knicks go the other way with it. Passes it to Barrett. Score that one for him. His 8th field goal. 8 for 11 on a very accurate night.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
And it's off the back rim. No good.
Probably not the shot that was drawn up for that possession, but you can't pass it up, and you can't knock it down.
incredible night for Barrett. He scores in a multitude of ways, and he brings the effort on every possession.
Morris, no good. Knicks trail by 17. And there's the pass to Knox. Off target from the wing. Detroit's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed 5 of them. And that's a foul. It's called on Wayne Ellington. That is his first foul of the game.
And the next one puts him in the bonus.
Taj Gibson's checked in for Julius Randle. Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over.
And doesn't like how things are going right now.
The timeout before the timeout here, maybe just to cut off the momentum and have a chit-chat with the team to settle down.
Chance to check out the stats for Frazier, how he performed last season. Put up about 5 points per, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. We know that he can come up with the occasional big play, but his overall numbers haven't been impressive.
There is a bit of a feeling they're all looking to him to step up, and they know he's capable of doing it right now, just not getting it done.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
And this is what dominating the glass looks like. He just cannot be contained.
Sort of reminding me of a little Ben Wallace action here from his years with the Pistons. He's been that much of a force rebounding the ball.
Bobby Portis has checked in for the Knicks. Knicks trail by 19. Here's Trier. Lays it up and banks it in. Trier's got his second bucket tonight.
Now that play never gets old, Kevin. The pick and roll will still be an offensive staple 100 years from now. Trust me.
And he's really made the most of his opportunities today. I mean, he needs to keep working for those kinds of looks.
Rebound, Detroit. Now here's Drummond, 16 points for him. Here's Morris, and there's another one for the Pistons.
To leave a guy like that wide open from range, big mix-up.
Pass to Barrett. To the paint, and Portis throws it down.
Timeout.
And credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, why settle for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that?
Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over. And for a lot of these kids, Greg, it's interesting how quickly teams expect them to get up to speed. Case in point, R.J. Barrett.
Yeah, I mean, he had only the 1 year of college, already being asked to produce. Fortunately, he's very mature for his age and generally plays up to the level of competition.
So for the Knicks, Morris is checked in for Barrett, and it's Reggie Bullock in for Wayne Ellington. Langston Galloway is checked in for the Pistons. Here's Frazier.
And that's an example of playing big, adapting to the situation.
tip of the cap there. I mean, that defense was good. The finish was better.
Trier passes to Portis. Bullock dishes to Morris. Nailed from three-point land. Morris has got 7 points in the game.
And the one thing about Morris, he doesn't scare you from beyond the arc, but you still have to account for him.
Here's Dumboya. That shot missing. Great D that time from Portis. Knicks trail by 18. In the corner, it's Morris. And the Knicks hit again from deep.
Yeah, there's 6 points on consecutive three balls. They're finding holes now in the deep.
Here's Dumboya. And it goes down 2 points. Dumboya's got 4 points now in the quarter.
I love the unselfishness, and you know coaches do as well.
Well, not just coach, but you can see it in the teammates, the way that they look at him. They appreciate it when he shares the ball like that.
And an excellent pass by Morris, a guy known for his finishing ability, but he also has the skills to facilitate.
That's good from Dumboya.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
He's perfect from the line this time. Knicks trail by 17. Here's Trier. Here's Gibson. Oh, yes, he did. 5 up and 5 down for him so far.
Tough to throw Gibson off. When he's looking to score, he powers through whatever defense is there and gets it done. Of all the action happening there, Kevin, it's the assist that jumps out to me there. That's just a great look and a great setup for the bucket.
Feeds to Morris. He gets that one to drop. He's now 5 of 12.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Here's Drummond, and Detroit again with the bucket.
Now that basket must be widening out right now, Kevin. He's making almost every shot he's putting up this quarter.
Here's Portis, and Portis throws it down.
Yeah, he just punched the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam, and Gibson sends it back.
Taj Gibson doing a good job of just getting the hands up, and then the instincts come into play with the block.
And that's out of bounds. Detroit will retain possession. Let's take a look at the players who were the best on the glass a season ago. Number one, Andre Drummond.
And, you know, he took a lot of pride in being at the top of that rebounding list. When all was said and done, he was a man among boys.
But he recovers it.
Yeah, just nice hustle there. That work gets them the extra possession.
Here's Trier, outside Portis. They get a hand on it, and here we go. The Pistons, fast break, and it's Drummond with the jam.
With a large frame and a willingness to get physical, Drummond's a relentless rebounder.
Knicks trail by 17. On the wing, Morris. And again, it's New York.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Here's Galloway. Again, the Pistons score.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
Out to the wing. Deep two from Trier. And the Knicks good for two.
Their three-point percentage has taken a big leap here in this second half.
And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It's on Bobby Portis.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw good from Galloway. And New York making a change here. Smith has checked in. Then for the Pistons, Blake Griffin, he's checked in for Dumboya. Bruce Brown comes in for Luke Kennard. And Reggie Jackson subbed in for Tim Frazier. Galloway hits both of them. 1:16 left in the third quarter. And it's Smith with the ball. He brings it up for the Knicks. Trailing by 17. And the powerful one-handed slam.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
And the gamble paying off.
And it's Bullock missing. Pistons leading by 19. Here's Galloway. And Detroit again with the bucket. New York's gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them.
He just bangs down the one-hander.
Mm, two very easy points right here. Inside, deflects the pass. Pass to Bullock. For three, Smith. Rebound, Andre Drummond.
Oh, man, you know he'd love to have that one over.
Here's Griffin. The rebound by Gibson. Gibson's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. From the arc, it's hauled in by Brown. Brown's got his fifth rebound in this one. Griffin attacking, and he finishes nicely on the layup. Griffin's got 22 points.
Yeah, Griffin is very efficient when he's driving to the hole. Masterful at fending off defenders, too.
Blake Griffin getting it done for the Detroit Pistons. And of everything he's doing well, it's his scoring that you point to first. Already 22 points in this game. We'll get right back to the action when we return. Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
And definitely deserving of the prize tonight. How about the read he made here? Looking like a point guard, putting the pass right on the money.
So helpful to the offensive versatility when your bigs can create, freeing everybody up, and that cut was wide open.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. Okay, now let's reset our lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. On the floor for Detroit, on the front line, the talented duo of Griffin and Drummond. Then there's Jackson, then there's Brown, and it's Galloway in at the two spot. Smith the pass to Gibson. Here's Morris. And here's Bullock from the arc. Offensive rebound, Gibson. Can't cash in from close range. Pistons leading by 23. Here's Brown. Morris with the rebound.
That might not be the shot they want him taking, even with the D backing off.
He feeds it to Gibson. He gets it in there.
Taj Gibson's postgame continues to improve, that time showing a nice touch.
Griffin inside. Gibson on him. That shot by Griffin, no good. For New York, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. And it's Bullock missing.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. A lot of missing stats from the 60s and 70s, but if we could go back and look at those actual numbers, any players you think would really be catching our eye in terms of, wow, I didn't know that guy was that good, or he's better than I thought he was?
Well, don't we always look at the incredible, mind-boggling numbers of Wilt Chamberlain
yes,
and
yes.
Think, what was that guy
take
doing?
A break. Yeah. Take a break.
And we don't even have half of it.
No.
So Wilt Chamberlain comes to mind first. What I think about, Kevin, when that question comes up is how many great players through the 70s and also really through the 80s, because the three-point line wasn't accentuated enough, missed the opportunity to be even greater scorers. I mean, Jerry West with a three-point line.
Can you imagine that?
You got to be kidding me. So there's a lot of gap of those players, too, that also because of – changes in rules, and because the three-point line wasn't in, that we would be talking about in terms of nostalgia and their accomplishments with a much different voice.
Even someone as recent as Jordan, with the rules the way they are now.
Absolutely.
It'd be unbelievable.
With the openness of the floor, yes, and what Michael could do, as if he wanted to prove he could do more.
Exactly.
That's nice vision there. You see that pass, you make the feed before the defense has a chance to react, and that opens up a much better opportunity to score.
And here's the fast break. Barrett leading the way. And the basket by Knox.
You can tell that Kevin Knox ahead of time knew he was going to shoot that ball no matter what the defense was doing.
Jackson. The second chance effort. He can't hit that time. And New York the other way now. Randle left side. He blocks it again.
A defensive stalwart so far. That's six blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Brown.
Poked loose, and it's out of bounds. The Knicks able to retain possession here.
Robinson passes to Knox. New York moving the ball around. Poked away, stolen by Jackson. Here's Brown. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson. Jackson's got five assists tonight.
And running with a full head of steam, but completely under control.
Yeah, you think he's comfortable at that speed? He's done it so many times before. Just an absolute blur in transition, and that helps get the rhythm going.
And finished off by Griffin.
And the 2009 draft number one pick, Blake Griffin out of Oklahoma, right now doing everything on offense.
Knicks trail by 21. New York calls timeout.
And how often do players argue calls knowing that they are in the wrong? They know they're going after something that was the correct call.
Let's just say often, Kevin. I mean, you just never, the whistle.
Are they thinking ahead in terms of saying?
I don't think so. It's emotional. It's just an emotional reaction. I mean, you're out there running around and doing what you do, and you get a whistle, you're going to react to it like, I did something wrong. Why am I in the principal's office right now? I want to get my side out. I know you saw it. Everybody does.
It sounds like you may have done a lot of that.
I tried to avoid that, Kevin, that quite
did
frankly.
You? Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I don't think that it's healthy for you and your reputation. Mm.
And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. To the middle, here's Randle, and again another assist. Dishing it all over the place in this one.
He's tallying them up in bunches.
And Drummond throws it down.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finish hard with two hands on that stuff.
And it's Smith with the ball. He brings it up for New York. To the paint, here's Randle. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. And that's now 28 points for Julius Randle.
And I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
Baseline jumper, got a hand on it.
No, sir. Randle up there says, uh-uh.
Here's Barrett. Good work there as it goes. Barrett's got 12 points here in the second half.
Oh, great production on the interior right now. 8 straight from inside.
And that one's good. Drummond.
And that's just cold-blooded right there. He's taking no prisoners.
Confidence is sensational, and it feels like no one is going to stop him tonight from scoring.
No hesitation at all on the alley-oop. Saw his teammate with a pass to the hoop, and bang, lobbed it right up there for him to finish.
And he was ready for it when he elevated and made the catch.
I don't know if you push the panic button now, but that's the fourth personal. And he needs to stay aggressive out there. So it's going to be interesting to see how he plays moving forward.
Here's Barrett. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Barrett's got 25 points.
Explosive off the bounce with great body control. Barrett's most effective when going downhill.
And so here is New York, trailing by 17. Randle outside. Down low. Here's Robinson. In it goes for the eighth time in 10 tries.
Yeah, the man was wide open there, and Julius Randle understood the timing to get him the ball to get that score.
And the slam by Blake Griffin.
Well, those interior passes can be dangerous sometimes, but if the timing is good and you execute it there, you can get easy hoops.
And he converts the layup. Griffin's got 8 points here in this quarter.
And he has just been in a flow offensively. Terrific game. He has been the X factor.
That's good from Randle on the assist by Smith. 30 points for Julius Randle.
And you know, he's really been one of the few bright spots for them, trying to will this team to victory.
And the basket by Rose.
And you love to see Rose aggressively looking to score on the inside.
Knicks trail by 19. Out left to the wing. Here's Barrett. Another possession, another assist. And that's his 20th assist. Wow.
Just doing a great job at orchestrating the offense.
Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over. And Greg, talking to scouts about R.J. Barrett, they love the athleticism. But what makes him especially good is the work ethic and the confidence.
Yeah, some elite prospects will take plays off. This guy never does. He's not one that sits around and reads his press clippings. He's a warrior, a leader, and he's proven to be a winner.
He's checked in for the Pistons. Pistons leading by 16. Drummond passes to Griffin. Over Randle. And the shot is long. New York's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. To the inside. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup. Randle's got 32 points. Here's Griffin. Doesn't get it to drop for him. Some solid defense from Robinson. Smith on the wing. Guarded by Jackson. And another assist for him. The chemistry he has with his guys is impressive.
Keeping his head on a swivel. Actively seeking out his teammate.
And here's Smith. Inside, it'll go, and the Detroit lead is cut back down to 12 as they get that one from Randle.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
And it's Rose penetrating, and two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
And Rose not always focused on creating contact, but with his physical gifts, a lot of times he leaves the defense no choice.
Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw, good, Rose.
And that one goes in, two from the line that time.
And not a single free throw attempt in that first half, but he has been far more active since the break and drawn some fouls.
And Barrett gets it to go.
Playing from behind right here, not easy, but he is answering the bell.
Yeah, doing anything he can right now to get his team to cut into this lead and give them a chance.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Here's Griffin. Second shot opportunity, and it's in there. That's now 22 points for Rose.
And Rose playing a big role offensively. He's got to be a focal point of your defensive scouting report. No doubt he can hurt you.
Tries from 10, and that one hits back iron. Pistons leading by 16. Griffin attacking, and he uses the glass on the layup. Griffin's got 34 points.
And that's what Griffin does best. They're remarkable how he maintains control and schools the D.
Passes it to Knox. And it's sent back by Drummond. And here comes Jackson leading the fast break. Props in the layup for two. Jackson's got 12 points in just the second half.
And their balanced effort at both ends has hushed this crowd.
All night long, in control of the pace, and you don't want to let go of that rope right now.
Smith with it, and Rose picks him up defensively. And it's Smith missing. Here are the Pistons with the ball. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Robinson with the block, and he recovers it. A nice shot by Griffin. New York's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
I think Mitchell Robinson is one of those guys. We saw it last year. He might get four or five blocks a game. So many players tempted to shoot outside shots because Mitchell would play off of them, and then quickly he would get to them and deflect the shot. So incredible quick twitch fibers and quick to the ball to make an impact defensively.
The first one falls. And with Robinson, if he played a full 40 minutes every game, Brent, his block numbers would be outstanding.
Look at you, Kevin, digging into the per 36 minutes statistics.
Yeah.
I like it. He's a great rim protector. He has great activity down there. And if he can stay with the game plan, I think Coach Fizdale is going to find ways to give him more minutes in this season.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws. When it comes to choosing, Brent, the MVP, the Coach of the Year, the Rookie of the Year, all these different great awards, do you like the current voting structure for these big awards right now?
I don't mind the current voting structure. I don't know how you get away from what it is that, in terms of handing people ballots to figure out who it is that they think have earned those awards throughout the year, Kevin. What I don't like about the structure is that you have media members who are voting on things that have huge financial ramifications for organizations. And when that stuff happens with a player who's going to earn a supermax contract because he made an all-NBA team, what you're going to start doing is restricting smaller market teams from being able to afford the ability to keep their star player with the team. And so that needs to be fixed, and fixed immediately.
I do not like the media. Wait a minute.
Wait.
I am the media.
You are the media, Kevin.
Strike that. Let's rewind.
Can we delete that?
And it's good for two. Griffin's got 38 points.
Yeah, Blake Griffin right now working the inside game and has the skills to take you to school.
Down low, Randle. That one falls.
This is a one-man show right now. He's on a mission to get him out of this hole.
Here's Griffin. That's good, and it's Jackson with the assist that time. 40 points for Blake Griffin. And it's Smith with the ball. He brings it up for the Knicks. The feed to Barrett. And another assist.
25 assists. What an unselfish performance.
He has been a sensational playmaker. Griffin can't get it to go in. Knicks trail by 19. Knocks the pass to Randle, and Randle throws it down.
Elite passes like that are so hard to defend. He never had to break his stride. So full speed, 2 points.
Here's Kennard. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
Give them credit. They've worked hard all game, now looking to finish it.
No, a great job of getting in position to win a game. It's been an all-out effort from the squad.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
Dan Kennard came into the league viewed mostly as a shooter, but he's been able to provide much more than that.
I mean, better than you think when he puts the ball on the floor. Learning how to lean into defenders and step back to open up the shot is a better playmaker than he gets credit for, and we should see him take on a larger role as he develops.
Brown, good. There's a minute 40 left in the fourth. Now, here's Barrett. He's guarded closely. Robinson dishes to Smith. And that's good. Robinson picking up the assist. And that's 20 points for Smith.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Pistons.
They made more foul shots, and that was the difference.
That was a big advantage. The other team was defending with their hands instead of moving their feet, and they handed them a lot of easy points at the line.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year. And we watched one guy all night long, guys, and look at the stats just confirms what a dominant game he had. What a night tonight it was for Andre Drummond.
I just loved his defense. He took pride in swatting away a bunch of shots tonight and made his impact felt.
Brent, we have seen some international showcase games the last few years. Do you like that trend?
Oh, absolutely. I like the fact that our league, we know how global it is with how many players from different countries are represented throughout the rosters around the league. But for our game to travel around to London and to Mexico City and have an opportunity for those fans to see what NBA basketball is like, I think it's an absolute win for
the
NBA.
I'd like to see more, actually.
Well, more time for those teams. Yes. The timing of some of those trips for some teams are a little bit tough in terms of the travel, but their appearances there mean so much more to grow the game globally.
Looking at who's out there now for the Knicks, Bobby Portis has checked in for Mitchell Robinson. Gibson comes in for Randle. Dotson's checked in for Kevin Knox. And it's Peyton in for Barrett. Blake Griffin hits them both. And so it's New York with it. Smith, the pass to Gibson. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time.
Well, at this point, they're just trying to get back in sync. You want to play a good brand of basketball.
Consistency definitely is a key to some of the playoff performing teams. And tonight, they just did not find it in this contest.
Wide open look, and the Knicks getting another bucket right there.
Well, shots like this are going to help Dennis Smith Jr. get himself going, which is a defense's nightmare.
Time called here. The Pistons decide to talk it over. They're leading by 19. 46 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Andre Drummond.
And Kevin, it's a no-brainer.
He's controlled every aspect of this game, and it's just so fun to see a player perform at a level that's just higher than anyone else out on the floor.
On the road, in a tough atmosphere, he's taken on the role of star tonight. If one of their other players came up short, he picked up the slack to make sure they'll be walking out of here with a win. Here's Jackson. Shot goes down. Very quick possession right there. And the Pistons lead by 21. And so Payton will bring it up for the New York Knicks. The pass to Portis. He kicks it to Smith. Detroit with the rebound. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Here's Jackson and the dunk by Jackson.
Making every effort to put this game on ice.
You love that the guys are staying aggressive late in this ball game, just not wanting to let go of the rope.
And that's an intentional foul.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
Reggie Bullock.
20 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Payton. Lays it up off the glass.
Well, saw the opportunity, did Elfrid Payton, and inside, capitalized.
Lets it go from the wing, and the Pistons getting another bucket right there.
And they came in determined to take this one. It's going to be a happy flight home.
Yeah, when you step into an opposing team's arena and you can play with this type of composure, boy, that food tastes good on the way out of town.
Shooting for New York, Bobby Portis at the line for two.
The first free throw is good. Both shots good from the stripe. Outside Jackson. And so Detroit takes this one by a big margin. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Blake, very strong game offensively. What gave you the confidence to take over?
I'm just putting in the work, and my teammates honestly believing in me and telling me to be confident at the end of the game. So I owe a lot to them. They came up with big plays. Just everybody working together.
Very good win for you tonight, Blake. Congrats. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And that'll do it for the first game of the NBA season. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. So long, everyone.